Good morning, everyone. We're continuing here in the Kitz of Shulchan Aruch and the laws of Shechiyonu Ve'atoy Ve'ameitiv. Says the Mishnah Berurah the following. Says the Kitz of Shulchan Aruch the following. Kona kelim shemishtamshim behem hu b'nei beisai. If items were purchased for the members of the, for himself and for the members of his family, mevarech ha'atoy ve'ameitiv, then the bracha over there is going to be Hatoiv v'hametiv, it is good and Hashem does good. Why? Because other people are benefiting from those items that are there in the house. For example, a person would buy themselves, it would seem, a brand new washer and dryer that everybody is going to benefit from in that house. The clothes are going to be washed. The brach is going to be Hatoiv v'hametiv. I would not make Shechiyonu in that case. And the Igros Moshe, Bar Moshe Feinstein brings down when a chassan gives his bride an engagement ring. So when he buys the ring, obviously a very expensive ring, he makes the bracha of Shechiyonu. When he gives the ring to the bride and she's going to put it on for the first time, she also gets a great pleasure from it. She should make Shechiyonu. But then she also makes Hatoiv Ameitiv on that ring. Why? Because there's also a benefit to the groom, because now his bride has an engagement ring, she's happy, he's happy, she is now ready to go to the next step, which is going to be marriage, so it's a benefit for all of them, and therefore she would end up making two brachas in that case. If a person was given a gift, Mevarech ha'toiv v'hametiv, he makes the bracha ha'toiv v'hametiv. Why? Shutoiv aloy, because the gift is a benefit for the one that's receiving it. V'gam la'neisin toiv, and also the one that's giving it, it's also a benefit. Kim zeh mekabel oni, because if the person who's receiving the gift is poor, harehi toiv la'neisin, so then it's beneficial for the giver, shezikoh Hashem yizbarach liten tzedakah, because Hashem gave him the ability and the opportunity to give charity, tzedakah to him. V'ma makabel hu asher, and if the one who's receiving it is wealthy, sameach ha'neisin shezeh mekabel menu matana, he's happy that the rich man accepted a gift from him. And therefore, the bracha in both of these cases over here is there should be a toiv ha'metiv. There's no reason for Shechiyonu, apparently. And that's because you are both the beneficiaries at the time of the giving of this gift, which is a very interesting thing to see, that even that when the poor man takes, he can also be a giver himself. Why? Because by taking the gift from somebody else, I'm giving them the schus, the merits, to provide me with things that I need. And that makes them happy. And therefore, by them being happy over the fact that I receive, or by giving them the schus, the merit, to be able to do tzedakah, so that makes them happy, I also become a giver in that case. And therefore, it's going to be a double direction over here of benefit, and therefore the bracha that is most appropriate is hatoiv v'hametiv. Now, one last thing that the Mishnah Berurah writes, that when a person has satisfaction of giving tzedakah or honoring a wealthy person for accepting his gift, if that would be very tangible benefit that a person could be able to feel, then even in that case, Shechiyonu would be appropriate and not Hatoiv HaMeitiv. Meaning, the one who is giving the charity or the honor of the wealthy person, that would receive a Shechiyonu and not necessarily a Hatoiv HaMeitiv. That's the opinion of the Mishnah Berurah. The Kitz of Shulchan Aruch seems to write as simple over here, that in this particular case, where both are deriving benefit, then Toiv HaMeitiv is the appropriate bracha. Wishing everybody a wonderful day. May you always be zeichet to be on the giving end and not on the receiving. All the best.